you.
Kevin L. Jackson.
I'd like the record to show that I'm not here on my own free will, and I'm here under protest and duress with the threats that are contained within the summons.
Okay, Mr. Jackson, you need to, that's fine. Come forward. I got your documents. Just state your name for the record.
Well, I've been told my whole life that my name is Kevin L. Jackson.
Okay. All right, so Mr. Jackson, I did receive copies of your filings, and I note for the record that you have an objection to this court having jurisdiction. And what I will do is this. First of all, let's see exactly what it is you are charged with. Hold on one second here. Okay, looks like you have a delinquent auto tax citation, Mr. Jackson, as well as no safety check and no insurance card on your person. The way that we are going to proceed at this time is that you have the right to give your explanation if you'd like to, and I will defer ruling on your jurisdictional motion for just a minute here. Explain to you, you have the right to give your explanation as to this, and if you or you can admit to the allegations, which I'm assuming based on your motion that you filed it, that's not what you want to do today. And then if you don't like my ruling, then you can go ahead and ask that this matter be set for a trial, okay, and a hearing. So how would you like to proceed today?
Well, I'd like to proceed with a demur.
Okay, and what is your demur?
That,
file that already?
No, I'm filing
okay,
it right
you need
now.
To file it before you can give it to the court. But what I do have is I have the filings that you did on January 24th.
Okay, well, is it possible to get a ruling on those now?
Yeah. Okay.
Also, may I ask if this is a court of record?
It is, and everything is being recorded.
Okay.
So that's another reason why I asked you to come forward, because if you want to make a record, which you have the right to appeal any decisions that are made in this courtroom, just need to be able to record it. So the only way to do that is to come forward and be able to do that. So I did read your, what I interpret as your 12B1 or 12B6 motion to dismiss on the basis of jurisdiction. And I will at this time deny your motion on the basis that there is case law in Hawaii that settles the issue of jurisdiction with the courts with respect to the type of motion that you filed. Like I said, you have the right to appeal that decision that I'm making. But having dismissed or having denied your motion, my next question to you is, how do you want to proceed on these underlying tickets or citations?
Well, I need to understand the nature and the cause of the charges and the nature and the cause of the jurisdiction.
Okay.
There were questions pertaining to the jurisdiction of this court, and I would like to know the true nature of this of the jurisdiction of this court.
Okay. Well, like I said, I've already denied your motion to dismiss based on jurisdiction. The court's finding is that I have both personal as well as subject matter jurisdiction under the law.
There are three jurisdictions that need to be proven.
Okay. And what is your third jurisdictional allegation?
At this time, I'm not sure.
Okay. Well, with I've denied the motion, so you, like I said, you can appeal that if you'd like, but with respect to the underlying citations, then what I can do is I can orally arraign you so that you are aware of what those charges are.
Okay, well, I need to understand what the nature and the cause of the charges are and under what jurisdiction we're under.
You are alleged that on or about January 4th, 2012, in the Division of Wailuku, County of Maui, State of Hawaii, you operated a motor vehicle on a public highway without having a delinquent vehicle tax. The citation alleges that the tax expired December 2011. In addition to that, on the same date and in the same area, you are also alleged to have not had a certificate of inspection that looks the allegation is that the inspection citation, the inspection sticker expired on August 2011. And then the third allegation is that on that date, you also operated the vehicle without an insurance card. The citation that you received on this date, which I notice is not signed by you, indicates the Hawaii Revised Statute sections that you are charged with. One is 249.2 of the Hawaii Revised Statutes for delinquent vehicle tax, 286.25 for having an expired certificate of inspection, as well as section 286.116, not having an insurance card in your person, on your person. Do you understand the charges against you?
I do not.
Okay. Do you want to enter admissions or do you want to deny the allegations? If you deny the allegations, what I will do is I'll go ahead and set this matter for a hearing.
Actually, I would like to ask a couple questions first.
Okay, well, I don't know if I can answer your questions or not. Go ahead.
Okay, well, the Sixth Amendment grants me the right to know the nature and the cause.
Okay, well, I've orally arraigned you on the charges. So those are, I've given you notice under the law as to what they are. You can go to the statute books and you can look up those sections. You have the citation as well. I know that the officer gave it to you. What's your next question?
Is this going to be a criminal action or a civil action?
These are decrim, decrim matters, so they do not carry, they carry fines only and fees, but no criminal sanctions.
Okay, the Constitution grants this court criminal jurisdiction under common law and also under the criminal jurisdiction of admiralty and military tribunal under Article 1.
These are not criminal offenses.
You just said that it was a criminal.
No, they are not criminal. They are civil in nature.
They are civil in nature. Okay, well, I'm going to ask that the case be dismissed because we're in the wrong venue. This matter would need to be in a federal court because the state cannot be a party in a case where the prosecutor and the judge are hired by the state.
Okay, your motion is denied.
On what grounds?
Because this court does have jurisdiction under the laws of the state of Hawaii, so I'm denying your motion on that grounds. It's not a federal. You know what? You need to go step outside if you can't control yourself. Okay?
Okay, well, if this matter is going to be a civil, I also ask that it be dismissed on the grounds that that there's no signed, sworn complaint and that there's no party complainant present.
So if, Mr. Jackson, I can set this for a hearing on that motion. If you want to file a written motion, then we'll give the state the opportunity to respond to that, okay, your oral motion that you're making. But in the meantime, that's what I'm going to do is to set it for a trial de novo and a hearing on any motion that you wish to file other than a motion to dismiss, which you have filed and I've already denied.
Is this a common law civil matter then?
This is a statutory civil matter. Not a common law civil.
I'd be willing to accept that if you could show me where I can find the civil rules of procedure for statutory law.
What you want to do is you want to look up on the citation that you received. There are references to three different Hawaii Revised Statutes, okay? And those are the statutes that you've been cited with. So,
the Constitution of the United States does not grant this court statutory jurisdiction.
Well, you can put it in writing and you can argue that, but I've already denied your motion. I think on similar grounds, so I don't want to rehash that at this time. You can, like I said, appeal my decision if you don't like my decision, but that's what the court's ruling.
Okay, well, I would like to...
You want to set this for a hearing?
I would like to set this for a motion hearing.
Okay. We'll go ahead and set this for what we call trial de novo, which means that we will proceed to trial. The state will be obligated to bring witnesses to court. You also have the right to put on a defense. So if you want witnesses to testify on your behalf, you need to have them at trial. We'll also have a hearing on your motions prior to trial. Okay? All right. So let me get you a date. Mr. Jackson, is set this for hearing on March 7th at 10 o'clock in the morning for a trial. Well, actually, I'm going to set that in the afternoon.
March 7th? I'm not waiving any of my rights to a speedy trial.
Okay. So noted for the record. Do you want this set in the afternoon if this is a TDN?
Yes, please.
Okay. So we'll go ahead and set this on March 7th at 2 p.m. for a trial de novo as well as a hearing on motions. If you're going to file motions, Mr. Jackson, I'm going to ask that you get them filed. Let's see.
March 7th, isn't that over 30 days?
Yes.
Okay, well, I'd like my hearing. I'm not waiving any of my rights to a speedy trial.
Well, you don't have the right to a speedy trial on a civil decrim matter. And it is within 180 days of the citation. But if you can get your motions, any other motions that you are going to file, please have them filed no later than February 15th. And I notice that you have an address on here. Is that your mailing address, the Kihei address? Is that your mailing address?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, so any response that the state wants to file needs to be filed no later than February 29th? February 29th for the state's response, and then they will have to mail you their response so that you receive a copy of it.
On for what matter?
Any motions that you file, you need to file by the 15th. And then they're going to have until the 29th to respond and get that to you in the mail.
Is it possible that I have a couple more days on that matter, because I'm not a lawyer and I will need time to research and make sure that all my paperwork is proper?
Okay. Let's see. Today's the 2nd. That's almost 2 weeks. Can't get it done in 2 weeks, you don't think?
I suppose I could.
Okay, if you want to get this trial, I mean, you're objecting on one grounds because you don't want it to be too long, which is fine, but I need to set those deadlines to give everybody enough time to respond. So I'm going to give you 2 weeks and then give the prosecutor 2 weeks to respond. So they'll have till the 29th. Okay.
Okay, so 15th, you said?
15th. And make sure you serve copies on the prosecutor as well as the court. And we'll see you back here for trial.
Okay. On the 9th, you said?
I believe was it March 7th? March 7th at 2 o'clock.
Okay.
All right, please see the bailiff. Thank you.
Thank you.